Hi, I'm Les. I'm here with Alex again today. We're here to talk about the economy. We're here to talk about some investment ideas. And we have a lot to cover, lots going on right now. So we want to make sure that you're informed.
So let's get started.
Okay. So it's kind of interesting. Last year, we spent pretty much the whole year fixating and worrying about inflation. And then the recession issue was more of a secondary because it really hadn't quite hit yet.
Right. Yeah. So for 2023, it's almost flipped. The primary concern this year is the recession. The secondary concern is the inflation.
Right.
So let's go right into it. Let's start talking about the recession first. Right. Last year, the end of last year, we started going into the recession. And the pain point for a recession is really unemployment. You know, the bad part about the recession is people lose their jobs. And right now, the unemployment is still relatively low. And the big but is now we're starting to see the corporate layoffs.
Right. It's a really odd labor market because we're still seeing, a lot more job openings than we see actually workers.
Right.
And that's going to change fairly soon right now.
Right. And it was a very dysfunctional labor market because for 2 years, well, not 2 years, but for an extended period of time, the government was paying people to stay at home, not go to work.
Right.
They were getting stimulus checks and kind of conditioned people to stay at home. So,
right.
So employers were having a hard time getting employees to actually come into
right.
work.
And so what's going to more than likely happen is as these layoffs, the announcements are already happening, but as the layoffs begin, you're going to start seeing the economy slowing down because those folks that get laid off obviously can't spend the same amount of money.
Right.
But that's by design. That's what the Fed wants to have happen. To fight inflation, they needed to destroy demand. The way you destroy demand is you have a recession.
Right. And we're starting to see it. Amazon announces about 20,000 right. People that are laying off, Microsoft.
Mortgage companies, financial institutions. I mean, we're seeing layoffs across all industries,
right.
Pretty much. And again, they're just trying to get ahead of the curve of as things slow down, they're trying to control their costs. And unfortunately, most companies control their costs first by laying off people.
Right. So the question is how bad and deep of a recession are we actually looking at? At this
right.
point, we're not entirely sure.
Right. Yeah. It's too early to tell in the game in terms of, how many people are going to be laid off, over the next. Keep in mind, for every one percentage point that the unemployment goes up, that's about 1.5 million people mm-hmm. that lost their jobs. So right now we're 3.5. They're projecting maybe 5.5, maybe 6%. So you're talking 3, 4, 5 million people that potentially could be losing their job.
Right.
So the impact of that is as people are losing their jobs, they can't spend as much money, which then affects the economy because you don't have as much spending. Mm-hmm. And so as more and more people get laid off, and it doesn't just affect the people that get laid off, by the way, anybody that's working with that person that just gets laid off is also worried about, well, am I next to go? So they're going to adjust their spending habits as well. So as we get deeper into this, that's where the effect is going to be. And obviously, as people spend less money, corporations spend less or have less revenue coming in, so their profits go down, and that's where you might see the effect on the actual stock prices.
And this is by design. This is exactly what the Federal Reserve wants. They want to
right.
slow down the economy. Okay, well, let's switch over to the secondary concern that we have regarding inflation.
Right.
The recession.
Because that's not gone yet.
No, it's not. Recession was the primary. Inflation is now the secondary.
Right.
And the good news is that the last few months, we have seen inflation subside a bit. It peaked out about 9.something%. It's about 6.5% right now. So that's the good news. It is coming down. It does not, like Les mentioned, though, it does not mean it's gone. No, the fear is that it could flare back up again.
And also keep in mind that a lot of the reduction we saw was in primarily energy and food.
Right.
Okay. And so those are the most volatile components. The core inflation, which is what the Fed looks at, did not go down substantially. So that's why the Fed is still nervous mm-hmm. about this potential that we could see a flare back up of inflation.
Right. And one of the factors that we're concerned about, which could cause inflation to flare back up, isn't necessarily domestic. There's some concerns there as well. But one of the bigger concerns is actually overseas. One of the things we've been keeping an eye on is the actual dollar.
Right.
One thing that's kept this thing going for us is the fact that the dollar stayed relatively strong. One of the concerns right now is Saudi Arabia overseas is talking about now accepting other currencies instead of taking just the dollar,
right.
which is the petrodollar. So what we're potentially looking at is the beginning of the end for the petrodollar, right, where they're now talking about accepting the yuan as well, a petrol yuan.
And I know that gets a little bit technical, and, right, and we, you know, we're getting down into the weeds, and we're trying to keep this simplistic. But that is a major issue.
Major issue
that we have to be, you know, tracking and, you know, keep tuned, because we'll be talking more about that as we do these videos.
Because the concern there is if they do accept other currencies other than the dollar, which gives us the world reserve currency status. If they start accepting other currencies, what we'll see is the dollars overseas, which is trillions of dollars, right, overseas, start coming back home. Right. And if those dollars start coming back home, that could exacerbate the inflation problem. We could start seeing that flare back up. So overall, yes, inflation is down right now, but it does not mean it could go back up.
Right. And then the other issue is now we're starting to see China opening back up. I mean, right, they were under, you know, complete lockdown because of the COVID. Now their factories are starting to open up. So now we're going to start seeing, as those open up, there's going to be more pressure on natural resources, mm-hmm, obviously, you know, oil, you know, commodities in general, which then could again flare up. So it's kind of like, you know, if you got a campfire and you put the fire out, you still have those embers. You still have to worry, even though the fire is not visible, it's those embers underneath that can flare up at any time. So that's why, you know, we're still putting it as one of the two big concerns. Mm-hmm. It's just now sitting behind the recession, right, unlike last year. Okay, so we just got done talking about more of a higher level, what's going on in the economy. How does that translate, though, down to your investments? I think that's what's the most concern for people is, okay, how does that affect me personally? So, you know, we're looking at right now that it's going to be, we think, a difficult 2023. We don't think it, hopefully it's going to be bad as maybe 2022.
Yeah, so for 2022, I mean, the market's closed down pretty ugly.
Yeah.
The NASDAQ, which is primarily tech stocks, closed down the worst, was down about 33%.
Right.
The S&P closed down about 20-something percent.
And those are your blue chip stocks. Those are your larger companies.
Right. And that's, you know, that's the more aggressive part of your portfolio, the stocks. But even the conservative part of most people's portfolio is the bonds. The Barclays Agg, which is the bond index, closed down about 13% last year.
And that's supposed to be the safe part of your portfolio.
Right.
Was down 13%.
And that's just the Barclays Agg. That's high quality bonds. And, you know, depending on what other bonds, you know, lower quality, I mean, you could have been down 15-18%, right, if not more. So it was a very, very ugly year. The only asset classes that ended up performing relatively well last year were commodities, right, specifically oil.
And that was really the first three quarters of the year. Even they kind of slowed down in that last quarter of the year.
Right. And then with precious metals, even most people were thinking precious metals were going to perform relatively well last year, and they didn't. And it wasn't until the very, very end of the year where they actually saw a little bit of a rally there.
Right.
And we think that will most likely continue into this
year. So, you know, basically, 2022, there was no place to hide. That was the frustrating part.
Other than cash.
And you know, we started getting concerned at the beginning of the year. The problem back then was that as you were selling off stocks to decrease risk, the question was then, well, where do you put the money? I mean, money markets back then were paying 0.1%. Treasuries were at what,
0.04%. 0.04%,
yeah, for 1 year treasury. So today it's a little bit easier because we have some breathing room. If you're still concerned, if you didn't, you know, lighten up on your stocks, at least now we have a decent alternative, which is, you know, you can go into safe money now, which is, you know, treasury, 1 year treasury is like at 4.7. So at least we now have an alternative to go to. So, you know, looking forward, and I think this is probably what concerns most people is that it's good looking back, but you know, what does the future look like? You know, we think the first half and especially the first quarter might still be very, very difficult.
Right.
I think,
you know, going back to the recession, what you talked about before, that's the main reason we think it will most likely continue to be a rough, maybe first and maybe second quarter, because the recession is going to worsen.
Right. And as long as the inflation is still higher, you know, like I said earlier, you know, it's three times above what the normal is for inflation. The Fed's going to have to be continuing to raise interest rates. Mm-hmm. Now, we don't think that they're going to be continuing to raise it the entire year. You know, hopefully they'll be done by first quarter, maybe, you know, going into the second quarter. But as long as the Fed's raising interest rates, stocks are going to continue to be under pressure. Mm-hmm. So we would,
and bonds too.
Well, and bonds too. Hopefully there that they'll see that leveling off a little bit. Yeah, but I mean, right now, it's the stocks that we're still concerned about. If you look at the major money centers, I mean, all of them pretty much are predicting somewhere between still a 5 to 15%, you know, potential drop in the stock market.
Right.
So there'll be a great buying opportunity, hopefully this year, hopefully, you know, going into the second half. But for right now, you know, we want to